proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, my kindness is established forever. In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever will I sing the goodness of the Lord. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Forever will I confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations. Forever will I sing the goodness of the Lord. He shall say of me, you are my Father, my God, the rock, my Savior. Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm. Forever will I sing the goodness of the Lord.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings, and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith. To the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Behold, I am the handmaid of the done to me according to your word. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. Behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said, "How can this be, since I have no relations with the man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her, who is called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, good evening, everyone. You know, I was on Monday, I was this past Monday, I visited my mom, who lives in my sister's house, my sister that has the 8 kids, and everybody was home, and my oldest nephew is now 16 years of age, and now, you know, as soon as he turned 16, he made his appointment, because it was just as the pandemic comes to an end, was opening up the DMV, he went in, passed the test, and now he's behind the wheel. It's a hard transition, you know. Just merely going from adolescence to adulthood, that's hard in and of itself. But, you know, it's much, much worse when parents have to teach their kids how to drive. You know, all the issues that you might have faced previously between the tough bridging of the gap between kids and grown-ups, it gets harder when you think the parents have to teach the kids to drive. And in this case, teaching, I think, is harder than learning. You know, because it's much harder on parents to relinquish control than it is for the kids to take control, to get behind that wheel. You know, it's not just a rite of passage for kids. It's a rite of passage for parents too. They get broken in when they have to teach their kids how to drive. And you know, in my case, maybe it was worse. I mean, I've probably had more accidents than anybody else in this church this evening, except for Father Vincent, maybe. I mean, I would just stay off the sidewalks if I were you. You know, but I think about my dad when he was teaching me to drive. For him, like, this concept of a junior license, you know, it wasn't good enough for him. It meant that that according to the eyes of New York State, anyone with a license over age 18 was sufficient to become a teacher, to be in the car with me, and that's all the supervision I needed. He wanted tougher restrictions. I mean, he wanted the law to require that I would drive, always be accompanied by at least a licensed paramedic, maybe 2 Supreme Court justices. You know, he also believed, like, there should be safety precautions, like the car should be attached by means of a strong chain as a restraining the device to something like Yankee Stadium. And you know, Mom wasn't any better. I think she would like, if there was the slightest, you know, quick stop I had to make, she would just automatically hit her head into the dashboard and say, "That's it, pull over, I'm driving now." You know, in any area of human life, it's hard to give up control. Especially, you know, when it seems like the person you're giving control over doesn't know what they're doing. Why am I talking about this? Now, here we are on the fourth Sunday of Advent, but the Vigil Mass, of course. And here we find ourselves with Mary. And she's being called upon by God to give up control. Here she is, a girl of maybe 14 or 15 years of age, and she's being called upon to become the mother of God. I mean, isn't it incredible that the salvation of the world would hinge on a teenage girl of 14 or 15 years of age? The highest of all vocations was hers. And yet, it immediately brought about many consequences for her life that she herself would have known immediately when she said yes to this angel that we just heard about. For example, how is she going to explain this to others? How is she going to explain it to her parents? Yeah. "Hi, Mom. I'm pregnant. Oh, I'm still a virgin. And by the way, the baby I'm going to have is God." That's a tough sell. Or how about explaining to Joseph, her fiancé? It was the Holy Spirit that conceived this child in me. You know, all St. Joseph had to do was one little phone call to the authorities, and she would have been brought in, and she would have been stoned to death. That was the punishment for what. Even though they were only engaged, it would still have been, in the eyes of the Mosaic law, adultery. He could have done that. Saying yes at that instant meant not only, you know, would she be holding in her arms this little body, but when she said yes at this instant, it also meant that 33 years later, she would also be holding his body again, but now full grown, stiff, and cold at the foot of the cross as it's placed in her arms. And if I put myself in Mary's shoes, I certainly would have thought, giving control over my life means allowing God to wreck it. Although, you know, it's hard for parents to give up control letting their kids drive. It's nothing compared to the control that Mary was called upon to relinquish to God in accepting this unbelievable gift. It's an incredible act of trust. And how does the reading end? "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." That's it. And it's worthy of noting, this incredible act of trust on her part is rewarded with an incredible grace from God's part. She now is carrying God inside of her. He becomes a human being. A microscopic little fetus inside of her. Heaven and earth are united in a kind of wedding inside of her when the Word becomes flesh and dwells inside of her. I think this example of Mary and her trust and surrender tells us everything we need to know about the spiritual life. But what God even calls us to. That just as Mary is called upon to relinquish control of her life and place it perfectly in God's hands, so are we. What we do not know is the great things that God will do for us if we give ourselves completely over to Him. When I say give ourselves completely over to Him, I mean without holding anything back. You know, we know that we can trust Him. We really can. Or to use the words of Mother Teresa that she told to our Archbishop. She said, when Cardinal O'Connor was ordained in May of 1979 in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome, it happened to be that St. Mother Teresa of Calcutta was there. And afterwards, he approached her. They had known each other some way. She took her bony finger and put it into his pectoral cross and said to him, "Give God permission. Give God permission." Or to translate those words of Mother Teresa, "Move over and let him drive." So how do we apply that in our lives? Move over and let him drive. Let's say there's trouble in our family. It always seems to peak around the holidays, doesn't it? It's who's not talking to whom, who's not invited to what, who's caught in the middle. What do you do? Move over and let him drive. Let's say, you know, the job's getting to you. Or maybe there's someone real close who got COVID, and or maybe you got it now. Or maybe you're afraid to get it. Someone you love's got it. You're laid off. Or maybe the bills are so high, you just don't know what's going to happen. What do you do? Move over and let him drive. You know, what if the bomb drops? You get news from the doctor, the lawyer, the police, the spouse, the son, the daughter. What do you do? What can you do? Except move over and let him drive. Sometimes we just don't trust him behind the wheel. We want to get back in the driver's seat. Or just stay on our side and just grab the wheel and start driving from the passenger side. We're so foolish. You know, in Pope Francis' first encyclical, he had this great line. And the great line he said was, he said, "Jesus hopes that we will enter into the reality of other people's lives and know the power of tenderness." And he said, "When we do, our lives will become wonderfully complicated." Isn't that a great line? Wonderfully complicated. When Mary said yes to the angel, her life became wonderfully complicated. You know, maybe you could see it like going for a bike ride. You know those two-seater bikes, the tandem bikes, the one person in the front and one's in the back. And when we first move forward in our spiritual life, it's hard because, that's actually the easy part. We're riding in the front, we get to steer, and then Jesus in the back seat, he's providing the power. That's great. I think God always, and when we're early in our spiritual life, we rejoice to feel God's power in our lives. And then sooner or later, sometimes sooner, sometimes later, he's going to say to you, "Let's trade places." He wants to drive. And you'll never be the same since. You know, when you're in control, when you can control the handlebars, maybe life is a little bit more boring, but it's at least predictable. And you go the shortest distance between two places. But when he gets behind, those handlebars, he knows delightful long cuts. He loves the curves, and he loves to go at them sometimes at breakneck speeds. And sometimes it's all you could do to hang on. And you want to say to him, "Where are you taking me?" And sometimes all you'll get as a response is, Keep pedaling. And eventually, we learn to trust. Often there's not much more choice than to trust. But we begin to forget our boring life and see it turned into an adventure. It becomes wonderfully complicated. And when we say, I'm scared, maybe you can feel him lean back and touch your hand. He'll take you to places, to people who have gifts for you. Maybe gifts of healing, maybe acceptance, maybe joy, maybe gifts for the journey. Or maybe you have gifts that he wants you to give to them in these new places he'll take on this adventure. Sometimes he asks you to give your gifts away. Too much baggage, too much weight. And so we do. Sometimes the people we meet along the way. And we recognize that in giving we receive. We don't trust him at first. But sooner or later we realize he has bike secrets. He knows how to make it through those sharp curves, to clear high rocks, and how to fly to short, but sometimes scary passageways. We need to learn to keep pedaling and eventually enjoy the ride to the strangest places and enjoy the view and the cool breeze on your face and your delightful, constant companion, who is Jesus. And when you're sure you could do no more, as the Blessed Virgin Mary teaches us, you will see him smile and say, keep pedaling. Keep pedaling. Brothers and sisters, let us please stand and present our petitions to God. We stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We turn to the God of love, who looked with favor on his servant Mary. May he look with favor now on these prayers and petitions we make.
For all God's people that are longing for Christ be fulfilled this Christmas, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our local and national civic leaders, that God bless and guide them in their service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those caught in the web of addiction, that they find true healing and lasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are lonely and depressed at this time of year, that they find hope and loving fellowship in this community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, particularly the members of this assembly, that they may proclaim the good news by word and example, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal intentions and for all whom have asked for our prayers, we pray for the repose of the souls of Félix Hernáiz, Florencio Rengel, Martin Cruz, Raquel Maldonado, María Mercedes Almanzar, and Ramón Soto. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Marcos Calderón, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In joyful expectation of Christmas, we place these petitions before you, our merciful Lord and God. Hear what we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, Patience, People.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid up on your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With you.
spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that we may find he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and bread.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Teresa of Calcutta, with all the saints whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, especially Marcos Calderon, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Power and the glory, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing our communion hymn, Maranatha. Jesus, give your people hope. Come, Lord Jesus, and lead your people home. Oh, of peace, make us free, justice for
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated, everybody. We have a few announcements to share. Just want to just go over the schedule here for the next couple days. Tonight we're going to have our young adults, we'll have like a bilingual concert, like probably starting around 8:45 here in the church. That's still open. The church defined, the diocese defines young adults as age 18 to 39. Just to mention that. Great opportunity coming up on Monday. We have Reconciliation Monday. This coming Monday, the 21st of December, we're going to have confessors here from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. So we want to get the late afternoon crowd and the early evening crowd, people after work. We'll have a number of guest priests here. So this is our best way to get ready for Christmas, to do our Advent confession. And so I just want to make sure everybody knew that not only will we be here, some people like to have a guest priest. Unfortunately, we won't be able to do behind the screen because of the social distancing, but we'll have several stations set up that allow us to practice social distancing for confession Monday, Reconciliation Monday, 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then the Christmas schedule. So Christmas Eve will be the 24th, Thursday, and our vigil masses will be 5 o'clock here. English. 7:15 will be in Spanish. The midnight mass will be at midnight. I know like in certain places they change the time, but here we're going to keep it traditional at midnight. And then on Christmas during the day, our Spanish mass 10:30 a.m. and the last chance 12:30 p.m. That mass is in English. I did mention last week as it's become a tradition here, the fourth Sunday of Advent, we give a special blessing to the expectant moms. Do we have any expectant moms here today? If we were going to ask them, we all look around eagerly hoping, but no worries. We'll try to some of the other masses as well. We choose to do this because on this fourth Sunday of Advent, we find ourselves with Mary, the mother of Jesus. She's expecting, and so we'll keep that tradition alive. All right, everybody, we could please stand for the final blessing in the St. Michael Prayer. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all of the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world seeking the ruination of souls. Amen.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, People Look East.
People look east, the time is near of the crowning of the year. Make your house fair as you are able, trim the hearth and set the table. People look east and sing today, love the guest is on the way. Furrows be glad, though earth is bare, one more seed is planted there. Give up your strength, the seed to nourish, that in course the flower may flourish. People look east and sing today, love the rose is on the way. shining beyond the frosty weather, bright as the sun and moon together. People look east and sing today. Love, the star is on.